In this lesson, we will discuss do while loops and do until loops. If you want a test condition to determine how many times a set of statements are executed, you should use a do loop. There are two types of do loops, do while loops and do until loops. Do while loops begin with do while, followed by a test condition, and end with the loop statement. The statements inside the loop are executed over and over while the test condition is true. A do while loop is terminated when the test condition is false. Do until loops begin with do until, followed by a test condition, and end with the loop statement. The statements inside the loop are executed over and over until the test condition is true. A do until loop is terminated when the test condition is true. A do while loop can be represented in a flowchart. We enter a do while loop if the test condition is true. As long as the test condition is true, the loop will be executed over and over. The loop will be terminated when the test condition is false. A do until loop has a similar flowchart, except the true and false statements are switched. In this example, a do while loop is used to calculate the sum and average of integers between 1 and 3. After running this code, four message boxes will appear. The first message box states, I equals 1, sum equals 1. The second message box states, I equals 2, sum equals 3. The next message box states, I equals 3, sum equals 6. And the final message box states, I equals 4, sum equals 6, average equals 2. Let's discuss why these message boxes display these particular values. The variables I, N, sum, and AVG are declared and assigned a default value of 0. Next, sum is assigned the value of 0. N is assigned the value 3, and I is assigned the value 1. Now we come to the do while loop. Is I less than or equal to N? Is 1 less than or equal to 3? This expression is true, so we enter the loop. Sum is assigned the current value of sum plus I, which is 0 plus 1. A message box displays the current value of I and sum, which are 1 and 1. I is assigned the current value of I plus 1, which is 1 plus 1 or 2. We reach the loop statement and evaluate the test condition. Is I less than or equal to N? Is 2 less than or equal to 3? This expression is true, so we enter the loop again. Sum is assigned the current value of sum plus I, which is 1 plus 2 or 3. A message box then displays the current value of I and sum, which are 2 and 3. I is then assigned the current value of I plus 1, which is 2 plus 1 or 3. When we reach the loop statement, we evaluate the test condition. Is 3 less than or equal to 3? This expression is true, so we enter the loop again. Sum is assigned the current value of sum plus I, which is 3 plus 3 or 6. A message box then displays the current value of I and sum, which are 3 and 6. I is assigned the current value of I plus 1, which is 3 plus 1 or 4. We reach the loop statement and evaluate the test condition. Is 4 less than or equal to 3? This expression is false, so the loop is terminated. AVG is assigned the value of sum divided by N, which is 6 divided by 3, or 2. And finally, a message box displays the value of I, sum, and AVG, which are 4, 6, and 2. We could accomplish the exact same task using a do-until loop. We replace do-while I less than or equal to n with do-until I greater than n. This means that the loop will repeat until I is greater than n. Notice that it's necessary to change the value of I every loop, or else the program would get stuck in what is called an infinite loop and run forever. If you get caught in an infinite loop, you can break out of it by typing Control and the break key. Placing parentheses around the test condition is optional, but it often makes your code easier to read. We can terminate a do-while or do-until loop early using the exitDo statement. In this program, x starts with the value 10. The statements in the do-while loop will be executed while x is greater than 9. Inside the loop, x is decreased by 0.2 every iteration. This means the loop has the potential of undergoing 5 iterations, with the value of x changing from 10 to 9.8 to 9.6 to 9.4 to 9.2, and the loop will be broken when x is 9 because 9 greater than 9 is false. However, if the value of x is less than 9.6, the exitDo statement will be executed, terminating the loop prematurely. When we run the program, 3 message boxes will display the value of x inside the loop, and 1 message box will display x outside the loop. Inside loop x equals 10, inside loop x equals 9.8, inside loop x equals 9.6, outside loop x equals 9.4. When x was 9.4, the exitDo statement was executed and the loop was broken.